This right here is the Battle of the Notes, an ultimate comparison between the Note 10 from Infinix and the Note 10 from Redmi. Since these devices retail for about the same price, have about the same configuration, and are smartphones from 2021, let's find out which of these devices is the best deal for your money. Actually, which of these devices you should buy right now. And so without taking much of your time, yo guys, let's get started. For the boxes, the Redmi comes in a slightly smaller white box. Both devices having the same available accessories. The only difference being, while you get an 18-watt fast charger from the Infinix, you get a faster 33-watt charger from the Redmi device. Also, you get a pair of earphones from Infinix Note 10, which isn't present in Redmi. So it's up to you, either a 33-watt fast charger from the Redmi here, or an 18-watt fast charger with a pair of earphones. The design choice is where things go in favor of the Redmi Note 10. Now, both devices are made out of plastic, but the Note 10 is more comfortable to use and hold. And that's because the Infinix device here has a larger display. I'll touch on the displays in a bit. You also have an IP53 water and dust resistance rating from the Redmi Note 10 here, which isn't the case for Infinix as far as I can tell. Other attributes like having jack ports, stereo speakers, actually the speakers on the Infinix Note 10 are louder than on the Redmi Note 10. Both also have a side-mounted fingerprint sensor. Dual SIM trays with dedicated micro SD card slots are about the same. Did I mention the extra feature like an IR blaster which you get from the Redmi Note 10? Generally, in terms of the build and design, the Note 10 from Redmi is the overall better device, more comfortable to use in one hand, and some better hardware choices were made here, like having more options in terms of camera and the display. Now, speaking of the display, while both devices boast of full HD plus resolutions in display, the Infinix Note 10 here comes with a 6.95-inch LCD panel, roughly 7-inch in size, and that's quite huge, which could be a good and bad thing, like better media experience for people who love huge displays. But the Redmi Note 10 takes it a step further by giving you an AMOLED 6.43-inch display, which isn't only brighter than what you get from the Infinix device here, but also gives you better colors, better contrast ratio, true blacks, and an overall better quality in terms of what you see. Here again, the Note 10 takes the lead for the display. Now for performance. You can get both devices at up to 6GB of RAM and 128GB of internal storage, but both I have here are 4GB of RAM and 128GB for the two devices I have on me. The Infinix Note 10 comes with the MediaTek G85 processor, which is a big deal when it comes to gaming for smartphones. But the Redmi here has the Snapdragon 678 chip, which is an 11-nanometer chipset. As opposed to the G85 processor, you have a faster clock speed, it performs slightly better, and that's even seen in a benchmark test for those devices. And it also has a wider support for memory clocks. Truth is, there is a wider support for Snapdragon processors right now in terms of optimization by developers. But the MediaTek G85 is a very powerful processor, and not that far off when you compare these two devices. Most users for day-to-day activities wouldn't really notice the difference in performance here. But the thing here again is that the Redmi has a little more powerful and power-efficient processor. Trust me, it isn't that much a deal in real-life use for these smartphones. By the way, you get Android 11 on both devices, MIUI 12 on the Redmi device, and XOS 7.6 here. MIUI has always been my preference though in terms of Android skin when comparing these two here. Now, for the cameras on the smartphones, the Infinix device here has a triple camera setup or configuration with a 48-megapixel main lens, 2-megapixel depth sensor, and a 2-megapixel macro lens. While the Redmi here comes with a quad camera configuration, 48-megapixel main lens, 8-megapixels ultra-wide, 2-megapixel depth, and 2-megapixel macro lenses. And that's for the rear cameras on here. After several tests, the only major difference between these two cameras, that's the major cameras, the main cameras I'm talking about, would be the field of view. The Redmi has a wider field of view, while the Infinix has this kind of taller field of view. As far as quality for these main cameras, they give you about the same amount of contrast, exposure, and detail. Sometimes the photos from the Redmi are less saturated, and I tend to pick the Infinixes in this kind of situation. I showed the photos to a bunch of random people now on a different neutral viewing device, and a higher percentage of people picked more saturated photos from the Infinix. You know, it looked more colorful. This also transcends to the low light photos, as the Infinix did a better job in that category, but both nice shots are not that great. The area where the Redmi takes the lead in the rear cameras would be in giving the users more option. You get an ultra-wide lens, which isn't available on the Infinix device here, and also a better edge detection for your portraits. I really do hate discussing macro lenses, especially when they are 2 megapixels, but the thing is, the Infinix takes the lead in this category, in the 2 megapixel macro lens. For the front-facing camera, you get a 13 megapixel sensor on the Note 10 from Redmi, and 16 megapixel on the Note 10 from Infinix. Again, these photos are very much similar. Only difference being the better edge detection from Redmi in terms of the portraits, and that slight edge makes the Redmi the winner here. Videos can be recorded at up to 4K resolution from the Redmi device, while the Infinix maxes out at 2K for the rear cameras. The front-facing camera maxes out at 1080p for Redmi and 2K for Infinix. I tend to prefer how the color is represented on the Redmi device here, and also the fact that I get to shoot 4K videos with the smartphone. But damn, these devices are really close in terms of the main cameras, with the Infinix giving you more saturated photos, which a lot of people prefer on a constant basis. Other than that, you get more options like an ultra-wide camera and 4K videos from the Redmi device here. It's up to you guys to choose which of these cameras you prefer. You have solid battery performance on both devices, and you wouldn't find anything to complain about in terms of the battery here. Both devices come with 5000 mAh battery capacity, which would last you through a full day of use. What you might want to consider here is the fact that the Redmi Note 10 comes with a 33-watt fast charger, which charges this device from 0 to 50% in 25 minutes, as opposed to the 18-watt charger, fast charger actually, you get from the Infinix device. You pretty much get about the same battery experience, but faster charging times come with the Redmi Note 10. For the units I have here, 4GB and 128GB of internal storage configuration, 83,000 Naira or $165 is what you get the Infinix Note 10, while the Redmi with the same memory configuration goes for 91,500, around $180, like a $15 to 7,000 Naira difference in price. So what's my verdict here? Which of these devices should you buy? In as much as these devices are quite close in a couple aspects, like having the same main camera quality, same battery life experience, about the same performance, this is slightly better though, I think it is worth paying that extra $15 for the areas where the Redmi Note 10 takes the lead, as that's incredible value for money. You get more options in terms of the camera, like the ultra wide, you have a faster charging speed here, a better performance from the Redmi device also, better phone to handle in terms of the size and form factor for one-handed use, and also the better display, AMOLED as against the LCD you get from the Infinix Note 10. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comment section below. Also hit on that like button, subscribe and share, as someone might find this video helpful on your timeline. Thanks for watching, and I'm gonna catch you in the next one. Kawidati.